So well, so SoundCloud is the leading audio platform. We have a very large and broad community of sound creators, you know, audio and music. So it's, you know, it could be brands, artists, bands, radio channels, really any kind of creator on the platform. We have over 10 hours of audio uploaded every single minute to the platform today, which is quite a crazy amount, and we reach over 200 million people every single month. So there's quite a lot of action on the platform. And I would say, you know, to say something about the history of the company, you know, SoundCloud started out, you know, relatively small and more niche, almost like a semi-professional tool for artists to share primarily music. But then we moved into sort of all categories of music. We started to go very broad, expanded into the US, and then in the meantime have all verticals in audio on the platform. So it's very much like YouTube or Instagram, where like on Instagram you share a photo, YouTube you share a video, on SoundCloud you share audio. Yeah, so a couple of weeks ago at South by Southwest, we launched a couple of new products that really helps not only sort of like the big music and audio partners that we work with, but also brands to essentially run campaigns on the platform and to represent themselves on the platform with audio. So we call them sort of pro partner profiles, and it's a more visual profile. So it gives this sort of like visual expression canvas for a brand to be on the platform and then sort of express themselves through visualized audio, you could say. So we have this component we call moving sounds, which allows the brands to sort of augment the audio they upload with a series of imagery. So they kind of the audio is still the main medium, but you can sort of augment with the kind of ambience of visuals. And then we also have tools that allow the brands to sort of promote their appearance on SoundCloud within the sort of native experience. So it's, you know, what the big trend right now is native advertising or promoted content, let's call it. We're seeing that working really well on some peer company platforms like, you know, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, and we're basically bringing that same model to the world of audio. So in the case of Red Bull, so we have Red Bull, we work with them on a couple of different initiatives. They just launched the other day now Red Bull Music Academy, which is a kind of a big initiative they're doing around the world, where they have these sort of workshops and get-togethers for sort of up-and-coming artists. They get to meet sort of established artists, producers, and so on. And it's essentially, it's like a, you know, the more intimate sort of session where they get to have an exchange, and then they, you know, they do concerts and stuff based on that. So they share really all the kinds of sounds that, you know, might be recorded around that those types of events. So in that case, for example, it might be an interview with a, you know, an established artist or producer. It might be, you know, a live concert that's happening. It might be a remix contest. So there are all kinds of varieties of audio that they might be sharing on that channel. And they're trying to really build a community, and they're quite successful at it as well, connecting sort of with the broad range of artists. And I think, you know, they have a strong affinity as well to what we are doing. So it works really, really well in that case. I mean, it's really the strong point of audio is obviously that it's kind of parallel, and you don't have to actually watch it while you experience it, right? So the thing is, though, that you first have to find something to play, right? And that first play interaction, that's really where you can grab the attention, both visually and sort of over the audio channel of the user, right? So you have that opportunity. And then, you know, after that, it might be that they, you know, they look elsewhere, or they, you know, they put the device in their pocket or something like this, and they continue listening. And then, you know, it's more about the audio channel, which could be, you know, branded audio to a certain extent, and yeah, you have to make sure that you can deliver the brand message both in the audio format and the visual side. We have, I would say, by far sort of the largest catalog of audio in the world, and we work very closely with, you know, all of the major labels at this point as well, and a lot of the major artists. So we really have sort of like a broad range of audio and music on the platform, and that's, you know, everything ranging from commercially released content to, you know, totally independent content created by somebody in their bedroom. And so, you know, we have the whole range. Discovery, I think, is a really interesting point. So that's something we're working on quite intensely as we speak. And, you know, we've rolled out certain things around discovery on SoundCloud. A lot of discovery also happens through other platforms. So we have integrations with, you know, Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, Pinterest, and some other sites. We're also on Flipboard, on iPad, and some other experiences. And I think there's a lot of discovery happening through those channels as well. You get sort of recommended something to listen to, and then you land on SoundCloud and can experience that and sort of related content from there. I think we're really excited about that and sort of taking the next steps together with the brands. We're, you know, we're excited to work with some even bigger, you know, bigger players in other verticals in the US that we're talking to now, and to further roll this out and to further develop these aspects of our community. So we really see these brands as just other community members, right? So they're on the same level as everybody else, and we try to sort of work with them to integrate this into the native experience of what we do.